With now over 10 years of experience, I've gone through some ups and downs, and throughout my career, I've learned things which I wish I was told before. And in this video, I want to give you 10 tips to make sure that you have everything you need in order to succeed in your career as a software engineer. Number one, master the fundamentals. So this is really crucial. I was talking to a friend the other day and he was telling me about an idea that he has, or I think his friends had, and it was like, oh, but I'm only going to implement this in Python. And I was like, that is the wrong mentality. And that's because he doesn't have the fundamentals. So what I would say is pick a language that will teach you the fundamentals that covers most of the other languages. So if you learn, for example, Python, then Python is not suitable for solving every single problem out there, right? So the same with JavaScript. And that's the problem, right? So here you don't have an idea of which language is best to solve a particular problem. So in my opinion, pick a language that will teach you a bunch of these concepts. So C++ is a good language, Java, C#, those are the languages that I do recommend in order for you to learn and grasp the fundamentals. Number two, keep on learning. So this is really important. As you know, technology moves at a very fast pace, and what you don't want to do is to be an engineer that is stuck in the past. So make sure that you read blogs, you follow the trends, see what's out there, read open source projects, and also even listen to podcasts to stay up to date. And with this follows number three, which is work on side projects. So myself, actually last night I was working on this side project, which basically allows me to translate all of my videos in a bunch of different languages. And I was like, how can I solve this using serverless? So I was architecting the application, and basically I've never done this, but still, like, I find it interesting and I'm gonna go out there and learn how to do it. And the benefit with this is that you keep on improving yourself day by day. So you're not just stuck with the stuff that you work, for example, but you are challenging yourself, making you a better developer. Number four, practice problem solving. This is really important. Yeah, so this will actually help you to understand how to solve problems. Now, I hear some people say, oh, I'm a Java engineer, or I'm a C#, or I only do JavaScript, or I only do front-end, I only do back-end. That is the wrong mentality. You should be an engineer. You should be someone that is willing to solve problems. And with that, all of that crap goes away. And what you do is you become a valuable asset in your organization. So now here, it doesn't matter on the language, you can embark on any project and tackle that as someone that is ready to solve problems. So LeetCode, HackerRank, and many other platforms help you to develop your problem-solving skills. And if you want to get into Google, Microsoft, Meta, all of these tech giants, then this is a skill that you must have. Number five, focus on clean code. But one thing is, how do you write maintainable code, readable code? Because as you work within a team, it's not just you, but you have to think about the other engineers that work alongside you. Now, if you just check rubbish, so just imagine that you go into a code base and people are just checking rubbish code at you. It's not nice. So focus on clean code. Number six, learn version control. So this is one which is really important, because as you start your career, it's really important that you know Git inside out. So this is something that you as an engineer will use every single day. And also to build your portfolio, right? So as you are becoming more experienced and you are applying for other jobs, then you have your portfolio ready to showcase, but also within Git, right? So within Git or version control, basically, you know all the best practices. Number seven, this is very important, and that is master debugging. So this is a skill that will come over time. And here, when I say debugging, I'm not just saying fixing a null pointer exception or fixing a small bug. But here I'm saying, for example, know how to use the debugging tools available within your IDE. Know how to use the environment, the monitoring tools available to you in order to debug an issue that happens in production, for example. So if you have a complaint, then you have all the tooling around in order for you to diagnose the issue. And sometimes it might not even be an issue with your actual backend code. It might even be within the database, maybe a transaction or a race condition. So make sure to master that, because as software engineers, this is something that we literally do like on a regular basis. And also profiling, if you're doing Java, I've done a video which showcased a little bit of profiling, but basically allows you to monitor your running application. You can see the performance, JVM, heap memory, stack, and all that stuff, right? So make sure that you understand exactly the debugging tools and how to use them. Number 8, communicate effectively. Just imagine you walk into a stand-up and you're given an update about a problem that you try to solve and you can't even explain. I know, it happens to all of us. Some of us might be nervous, some of us don't have the communication skills, but this is important because as you go through your career and you become more senior, if you cannot communicate effectively, then trust me, people will not trust you, right? So it depends really what you want to do. Do you want to be someone that will lead, or do you want to be a solo developer, right? So if you want to become someone that leads, then communication, it's very important. And with this comes soft skills. So this is number 9. So here, don't just be an engineer and stop there, right? So make sure that you can work efficiently across multiple teams. You can get along with people. You know how to talk. If an issue arises, you know how to solve the issue in the best manner possible, because that's what leaders are made of, right? So if there is something which is to blame, then you should be the one to take responsibility and not point fingers at your team. Okay, so soft skills is very important. And last but not least, network and seek mentorship. So this is one which you should act upon, because as you go through your career, your network are the ones that you never know, like literally never know. You might have a friend or someone that you work with and they have a startup, then you might get a recommendation. Or if you were known to be like reliable, then you know there's so many opportunities that can arise from it. So make sure to network and also seek a mentor. So this is so important, and at Amigoscode we try to have this community of developers where you can come in and basically ask us any questions, and we are there for you because we know the importance of having someone to guide you. So there's this sister from Sweden called Najima, and currently she's working at IKEA, and she said Amigoscode was so important because, you know, when she was stuck, she would hop onto the community, Discord more specific, and there's two other brothers that would help her, you know, find the time and explain. And so make sure to get a mentor, but also be part of Amigoscode community. If you enjoyed this video, literally just take 2 seconds and smash that like button. Let me know what you want to see next, and I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.